So in this episode, we are going to talk about auto-provisioning and call control in this P-Series Yeastar IP-Pbx system. So kindly sit back and watch me as I configure these features. So without wasting time, let's go ahead with our auto-provisioning. Auto-provisioning is simply to, in a smart way, configure your extension through the IP-Pbx system. You understand? Instead of individually typing the IP addresses of your IP phones, you can use the auto-provision to actually configure it straight from the IP-Pbx system, so that you don't bother with individually typing in the IP addresses of the phone systems where you try to register them individually. So auto-provisioning actually saves you time, a lot of time. So let's go ahead and try auto-provisioning. So you have the option to add individually or in bulk. Okay, so example, let's try individual. So under individual, if you come to vendor, you see the compatible brand which works with Yeastar IP-Pbx system. So these are the other brands that works with Yeastar. So let's try farm view. Then you select the model number. So let's say this is the model number, and then you specify the MAC address. So let me just address. Okay. Then if you scroll down, you have options for the template. Okay, so this is the template I want to use for registering of this IP-Pbx system. Assign extension. So let me assign this extension and then save. Yes. So this is my auto provisioning. So I've done for individual. Okay, so we are done with configuring auto provisioning for just an IP phone. Okay. The next thing is to add a bulk type of auto provisioning. So it's the same procedure. Okay, so I'm selecting SNOM, and then you select the models, the type of model, and then this is where you specify the IP addresses. Okay, example like this. Okay, something similar like this. It could be any number. Okay, you just have to specify it down here. Then you specify the template. Authentication for the first time auto provision, yes. Assign extension. You understand? So it tells you the start of the extension to the end. So I want to start from extension 102 to extension 107. Yes. So these are the MAC addresses. So let's assume these are the IP phones listed here. So you come here and then select the extension according to the number you've specified here. And so this is the first one. This goes to the second one. This extension goes to the third one, this to the fourth one, and this is the last one. Right, so let's go ahead and save. Already exist. Okay, I just need to change this MAC address to this. Right, let me go ahead and save. great. So if you look here, I've currently done an auto provisioning. Okay, let me go ahead and reboot them. So let's assume I have physical phones. These are with respect to your physical IP phones. This is not with regards to your soft phone. Okay, and that's the reason why you have vendors and the models. And so that is it with this auto provisioning stuff. It goes ahead. If possible, you can even go ahead and so basically that's it with auto. So if we come to call control, the first one to tackle is the inbound call, simply meaning calls that are coming into your organization. And so let's add a rule. This rule is about incoming calls. Okay, doesn't accept this. So incoming calls, right? Inbound alert info. Call coming. Right. Then the DID pattern. Match DID pattern to extensions. Match DID range to extension range. And so, or you just leave it here, DID pattern. Okay. Pattern operations. Then you add the kind of pattern. So the pattern I want is 0 0. Right. Caller ID pattern. Match contact caller ID in specific phone books. Caller ID matching settings. Okay. So you add. You select at least one trunk. Okay, great. A trunk needs to be selected here. And so these are my trunks. I mean, this is a trunk, IP trunk I've selected. Now, if call comes in through this trunk, who should receive the call? Okay, if it comes in, I want extension 100 to receive the calls according to the time condition we've set. Okay, so based on business hours, then you go ahead and configure your business hours here. Else, just leave it on global settings or just uncheck time condition so that you can receive calls anytime. Then go ahead and save. So we've created our first inbound. We've created our inbound call control. Okay, let's view this default configuration. Okay, so this has been configured as well. The next one is the outbound call. The outbound call is to tell the IP-Pbx the extension that can be able to make call outside your company or your premises. Okay, so there is a default one here already. Let's edit it and see exactly what is in. Okay, so this is the name, default outbound route. This is the pattern. And this pattern simply means you can start dialing from 0 to 9. It accepts numbers from that. And so most of our phone numbers are configured in such a way that it starts from 0. Okay. And so you select the trunk. Folks can make calls, outbound calls through. So this is the trunk. Outbound route password. Okay, so you can enable this if you want to protect the calls that goes outside, so that nobody can easily make calls. Okay. The next thing is to select the extensions that can make calls outside. So in this case, I want this extension, this guy, and this guy to be able to make calls out. The rest cannot be able to make calls out. Okay. And then time condition. If you choose any time condition, it's going to act on based on the time condition you select here. So you go ahead and save. Right. So basically, we've created our inbound and outbound rule, meaning calls that can come into the premises and to which extension, and which extension can be able to make calls out to the outside world. So we come business hours. So this is where you actually configure your business hours and holidays. So example, let's add a business hour. So we have the start time, end time, and operations, right? So let's go ahead and add a business hour. Start time is 8 o'clock. 8 o'clock, right? End time is 4 o'clock, right? That is if my break hour is 12 o'clock to 1 o'clock. Which is 13 hours. Okay. So this is my break. Let me take. Okay, so this is the point at which you choose the days of the week you work. So I work from Monday, Tuesdays, Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays. Okay. Or you can come to advanced and select the months. So I work from January, February, March, April, May, June, July, November, October, September, August. Maybe I don't work in December for various reasons, and maybe June. These 2 months I don't work in them. You can go further and choose the dates. Okay. So I work the whole days. Okay, and then you can go ahead and put a remark here. When you are done, you just save. So I've just created a time condition, right? You can go ahead and add a holiday. Let's say Christmas. Let's say Christmas type by dates. Okay, so by date. Okay. So this is what I've done for the Christmas season. So I've created business hours and then holidays. And then when you go down further, this is where you can add the emergency numbers. Okay. There's a police. Emergency number 119 or 999. Trunks emergency outbound caller ID. Trunks emergency outbound caller ID. Okay. Then you add the trunk. And this is the trunk. Emergency number caller ID. And then you can save. So basically this is it. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you now have a clue on how to deal with these two features I just tackled. You remember we just tackled auto provision and call control in this Yeastar IP-Pbx system. Thanks for watching this video again, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to share my videos, like my videos, and your comments are expected. Thank you.